Good morning, children. Today, let us learn Unit 5. The name of the lesson is A Visit to Remember. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the Warli tribe, how they live, how their homes were made of, and what materials did they use to make their homes, and what do the symbols in the wall painting signify, etc. But before that, let us learn some hard words. The first word is visit. Second, Warli tribe. Third, destination. Fourth, incredible. Fifth, numerous. Sixth, geometrical. Seventh, fascinating. Eighth, communication. Ninth, occasion. And tenth, abundance. And the meanings are, the first word is destination, a place where someone is going or being sent. Geometrical, the geometrical means characterized by regular lines or shapes, which you will come across in your math subject. Next, modernity, qualities associated with the present and existing. Fourth, incredible, means impossible to believe. Next, crude, in an unrefined state. Next, fascinating, which means interesting or appealing. Next, scribbled, wrote carelessly. And we have some more meanings in the lesson. You can go through the lesson as well as meanings if you don't understand or if you have any doubts. Okay, now let us go to the lesson. I'll give you a small example. When you go or visit to an important place of any country, you will feel excited and curious to know about the place, and you will collect all the information from your guide and will make note of it because it is a very important place to know the history of that particular monument or any place of different country. So like the same manner, let us look into the lesson and see where Mikhail and Junita went and what all things they came to know at the end of their trip to the Warli tribe. So Mikhail and Junita were walking through the streets of Thane in Mumbai. The streets were very busy that they could not walk without touching each other. Their guide was Vishwas. Guide means a person who shows the way to others, especially to the tourists around places of interest, is called a guide. They were going to visit the Warli tribe and both of them were excited, and it was their first visit to India. That too, to see tribal art, which is a stylish art of the tribal people. So the word Warli means the tribal people living on the borders of northern Maharashtra and Gujarat. Warli is a word which is derived from the varal, which means a small piece of tilled land. They actually live in a forest. So Vishwas started explaining them about the Warli tribe. It came as a surprise that the Warli tribe lived in tiny houses, one next to the other. It was not a village as Mikhail and Junita had thought. Vishwas said the walls of the huts were made of branches, cow dung, earth, and red background for the paintings. So this is a conversation between three people, that is Mikhail, Junita, and the guide, Vishwas. So Mikhail asked Vishwas, how old is this art? Vishwas said, you will be surprised when I say something about this art. New researchers says that origin of this art might be 2500 to 3000 BC. Means that much old is this art. Junita says, wow, incredible, which means they could not believe. She couldn't believe what she heard. They saw the wall paintings. There were numerous circles, triangles, and squares used in different patterns. Then Mikhail asked Vishwas. He was curious to know about these paintings and asked his guide, Vishwas, that what do these geometrical shapes denote? Is there any meaning to these shapes? He said, well, these shapes come from the tribe's observation of nature. The circle denotes the sun and the moon. The triangle that you see in abundance is inspired by the mountains and trees. The square denotes a piece of land, said Vishwas. Then Junita asked, is there a story in each painting? Then Vishwas said, if you look closely, you can see that they all denote some day-to-day activities like hunting, fishing, and farming. Sometimes even festivals are depicted in the paintings. Then Mikhail asked, what is the white stuff that is used for the painting? Vishwas said, it is a rice flour mixed with water and glue. They don't use the regular brush that we get in the market. Instead, they use a bamboo stick, chew it on one side to make it a flower and use it as a brush. Junita made notes in the book. So Mikhail asked, what is a concentric circle of triangular figures? Oh, that is tarpa dance. Tarpa is the trumpet-like instrument that you see in the middle. Men and women take turns to play it. They are all holding hands and move in circles around the tarpa players. This circle formation also denotes the circle of life, Vishwas said. Then Junita says, that's a lot of information that you gave us, scribbled furiously in her notebook. Next, Vishwas said, there is more in most paintings. The central motif is square, known in native tongue as chalk. There are two types of chalk called Dev chalk and Lagna chalk. A figure known as Palagatha, the mother goddess, she represents fertility. They moved heart to heart and found that the paintings were more or less the same. Then Vishwas said, till the 1970s, this kind of paintings was done by the women folk. But as I said earlier, it was done only on special occasions. But now a man by name Jivya Soma Mashe and his son Balu Mashe took up Varli paintings purely for the love of this art. Then Mikhail said, is there anything being done to protect this art form? Vishwas said, they have patented this art form. It is actually a cultural intellectual property of the Varli tribe. The Adivasi, Yuva Sena Sangh and the Varli Art Foundation are associated with the art form and various related activities. Then Junita asked, where can we buy something with Varli art on it? We would like to keep something for memory's sake. That's not a problem. Many designers are using the unique Varli art on their clothes. We can buy them in various shops. Shirts, skirts, blouses, and even shawls have the Varli prints on them, Vishwas said. And Mikhail, that's wonderful. Please take us there. Junita says, before we leave, Can we take some photographs with these artists? Why not? They'll be only too happy to pose for you, said Vishwas. Thus, Mikhail and Jinita made memories with the artists of Wali tribe. The visit to see the work of these unique tribesmen was truly an enriching experience for them. And Mikhail says, we have a lot of things to tell when we get back home to America. Vishwas said, thank you. If you make a small donation towards the protection and welfare of these artists, they would be grateful, said Vishwas softly. We'll be very happy to do that, said Jinita. On the way back, they brought many things with Wali Prince as gifts to give to friends and relatives back home in America. They also had a big story to tell about the circle, triangle, and square. So that's how they come to know about the Wali tribe, and they explained all the things, what all they have seen to their friends, relatives, and family members when they went back to America, their native place. So now let us go to the B part of the lesson, that is the young man and the monster. The young man and the monster. It is a story about an young man, monster. Let us look into the lesson. Long, long ago, there lived a brave and fair ruler named Vikramaditya, who ruled the kingdom called Avantika. He was a ruler. He was a great king and ruled the kingdom called Avantika. The young king was kind-hearted and would always help the ones in need, and the people loved the king and always praised him. One day when King Vikramaditya was sitting in his court, an old sage entered. He said, O king, I need your help. There is an evil celestial tree spirit by name Vital who lives in the forest. This spirit hangs from a tamarind tree and causes trouble to a lot of people. Now, I want you to catch him and bring him to me. I will wait for you in cremation grounds. I will bring his existence come to an end with my mystic powers. The king was a brave man and never refused to help anyone. He agreed to fulfill the sage's request. Thus the king went into the forest that night to look for the spirit whose name is Vital. Soon he found Vital hanging upside down from a tamarind tree. Armed with his sword, the brave king caught Vital. The king then placed him on his shoulders and started carrying him to the cremation ground. Cremation means nothing but the disposal of a dead person's body by burning it. When a person dies, they will take that body and they will burn it. That is called cremation. So on the way, Vital said, O king, I will tell you a story, and after the end of a story, I will ask you a question and you should answer it correctly. And if you are not correct, I shall kill you. And if you are correct, I shall flee to my tree again. After saying so, he began narrating the story. An old man was once traveling through the forest. The man looked around trees and beautiful green grass. The birds chirped merrily and trees and the squirrels danced on the ground. When he was looking all of these things, a terrible monster emerged from the bushes and roared, I'm going to eat you, old man. Be prepared to die. And this old man was trembled and said, please leave me, O great monster. I will provide you with much better and healthier food and this monster agreed and told him to send the food soon or else I will kill you. So the old man rushed to his village and met his young son and told everything what all had happened in the forest and requested him, saying that to save him from the monster. And this son laughed at his father's request and agreed to save him. Thus the old man's son went deep into the forest to face the dangerous monster. After some time, when the monster saw the young man, he licked his lips. Ah, this young man would have such delicious meat. He looks so healthy, I shall kill him at once. Then the monster jumped on the young man. However, he is very much brave and fought monster with his hands, and before the monster could harm him, he caught his neck and killed him. At this point, Vittal stopped the story, asked Vikramaditya question. Why did the young man laugh after hearing his father's request? Answer me correctly, or I shall kill you. The king answered, the young boy laughed because he understood how selfish and cruel the ways of the world were. His own father was ready to sacrifice his own blood in order to save himself. This truth made him even stronger, and he was able to defeat the monster easily. Vittal was impressed with the answer. Since the king had answered correctly, he returned to his place in the tamarind tree. So this is about the story between the young man and the monster. So these are there are some meanings. Dead person's body by burning it. Next, generous. Showing a readiness to give more of something. So these are the meanings we have in the lesson. The next section we have is the words which will have same meanings. So we have. So the next word is caring. Caring, which means kind. Next word is problem, the trouble. Next word is dreadful, terrible. So we have some question and answers also in the lesson. We'll send the question and answers through PDFs. The next up, fill in the blanks using appropriate possessive pronouns from the given options. We have options in the blank. Whichever the correct word, we have to write in the blank. That's dash pen. That's my pen. Blank is filled with my. Next, she has broken dash leg. She has broken her leg. Next, my toy car is not working, but dash is, but hers is. Next, these are the fill in the blanks that we come across the lesson. Now let us go to the grammar part of the previous lesson. I have told you the previous lesson, what I've told you is a visit to remember. So the first section we have, find and write down a smaller word hidden in the given words. One has been done for you. So we, from the words only, we have to find another word, small word. So example they have given you here. Slaughter, the first example they have given you is slaughter. In slaughter, we can find out another word which says laugh. The next, the first one, compassion. So we can form another word which says passion. Then second one is compromise. So from this, if you remove COM, we'll get. The next one is fortitude. So we can find the word fort. Next, forbearance. We can form the letter, we can form the word forbear. Next, abstain. You can take the word stain. Next is abate. We can form another word which says eight. So next section we have, find the words in the story that have the opposite meaning of the following words. So these are the opposites. We have to find out the correct word. The first one is isolated. Isolated opposite is crowded. Isolated means where one person lives out there. Crowded means there. So we have true or false. Mikhail and Junita were disappointed to see Wally tribe. They are not disappointed. They are in fact happy, and it is not true. It is false. Wally paintings is done only on regular basis. No, false. The next word. Wally tribes live on the outskirts of the city in tiny houses next to each other. Yes, is true. Fourth, white paint and paintbrush is used to make Wally art. False. Next, Wally art was taken by Jivya Soma Mashe and Balu Mashe for the pure love of the art form. Yes, it's true. The next section we have, the pronouns. We need to use the pronouns in the sentences. Pronoun is nothing but the substitute word of noun. When we replace the word noun into another word, it is called pronoun. So we should underline the pronoun in the sentences. So what is his name? His is pronoun. So you should underline his. Next, what are you doing here? You is underlined here. Next, he is my cousin. So you should underline he and also my. Next, I don't like reptiles. Next, I is the pronoun. So these are the pronouns. You have you can make some more sentences using these pronoun words. Next, we have fill in the blanks using appropriate personal pronouns from the options. They have given you the options. From that, you have to select a pronoun and write in the blank. Dash, I'm Leela's sister. I am Leela's sister. I will come. Next, Dash are going for a picnic. They is a pronoun. So they are going for a picnic. Next, let Dash go and play outside. Let us. You should write us there. Next, Dash have a dog named Scooby. I will come there. I have a dog named Scooby. So last one, Pushpa's father has brought a gift for Dash. A gift for her. So these are some of next. We have the writing part. You have to write a few lines about the picture which is given at the end of the lesson. Look at the picture given below and study the actions that is going on. Write down your observation of the picture. So when you have to observe the picture and whatever the actions are going on, you have to write and you have to write like composition in some words, some sentences. You have to write on your own. These are the grammar part of this lesson. Next to the previous that, we have listening and speaking, another section. It says, the teacher will read out a list of words. Listen carefully and pick two words from the list which are synonymous. Also make sentences with the words. Means it is like meanings. So the first one is miniature, means small. Next, you have to underline that synonyms. The next one you can underline is slippery. or slimy. Next one, protect, defend. Next one is serious and sombre. Next one, freedom, liberty. Next one, assortment, variety. Next one, shout, yell. Next one, worker, employee. So these are called synonyms in the lesson. So if you don't understand anything, children, go through the lesson and grammar part in your textbook and learn all of them, which is very important in your exam. And learn the question and answers also. And if you go to the lesson, go through the lesson once again when you prepare for your exams.